You know, I think it's really interesting because they say, like, as Americans, we don't want to feel the sadness. We don't want to feel, like, the bad parts of life. We want to always be happy. But I think it's really interesting that you wrote this song when you weren't at a particularly good time in your life. Well, here today on today's episode, we are with Adrian Chaparro, who is singer and songwriter. All right, going hot right now. So how are you doing today?
I'm doing fantastic. How are you?
Good, good. Okay, so you write your own songs, which is amazing. And this song that is going off the charts right now is Gracias. So you wrote the lyrics for that song as well.
That's right. Yeah, I write all my music. I do collaborate with other people too, but mainly for all the music that I sing, I write it. I wrote the song Gracias, and people have accepted it with a very good response, and people like it, and we're loving the results. We're thankful right. for them.
Como se dice, tú tienes las manos en la masa.
Así es, sí, pues tiene uno que hacer todas las cosas, a veces personalmente, y aprendes de ti mismo, y aprendes a ser mejor, y así que por eso nos gusta escribir nuestros propios temas.
Okay, well, perfecto. Entonces, ya teniendo las manos en la masa, tell us about the inspiration behind this song, because you were in there, you know, you wrote the lyrics. The inspiration of a little bit of the process and the production of it.
The funny thing about it is that when I wrote this song, I was, this song is about being thankful for the good and the bad and everything that goes on in your life. So, but what's funny is that I wrote this song when I really didn't feel very thankful, going through a hard time mentally because of my physical appearance. I was struggling with my physical appearance. I'm used to reacting to life in certain manners and in certain ways, but I decided to be thankful. I decided to be thankful for the good and the bad. So I wrote this song in inspiration from that.
So what is this song written like 2-3 years ago?
I wrote this song about 2 years ago.
Okay.
It was very different. Life was very different 2 years ago. You know, I mean, life could change one day, but
right.
2 years ago, life was very different in every manner. So yeah, I wrote about 2 years and I came out and people, they caught on to it slowly, but once they caught on to it, it seems to be the case that they like it a lot.
Yeah, and so what's interesting about that is that you pushed it out in 2019 and now you also released it as a single in 2020 live. And then it's also part of this live album that you put out also in 2020. So you're kind of really pushing the song forward, right? Throughout these past 2 years.
Yeah, exactly. We put the song out in 2019, I'm sorry. And like I said, it seemed like at first people really liked it and then like slowed down and then people kind of left it to the side. And then they started listening to it again. They started sharing it again. It's really because of people asked me to put out these versions.
Yeah, you know, I think it's really interesting because they say, like, as Americans, we don't want to feel the sadness. We don't want to feel, like, the bad parts of life. We want to always be happy. But I think it's really interesting that you wrote this song when you weren't at a particularly good time in your life. You know, it's actually quite the opposite. And you're still choosing to be thankful for those life lessons.
Yeah, exactly. And it's exactly that. I think it's a choice. I think being thankful is definitely a choice. Being happy as well.
I love that. When did you find out that you had a voice to sing? Because I imagine you started writing first, right? And you've actually written for a lot of other artists.
I have written for other artists. Mainly that's what opened the doors when we started in this music industry. But we've sang all our lives, like me and my brother. I have three siblings, so me and my brothers always sang, you know, like even when we were little, my family was always like bumping music, all go to the house, we had a little karaoke. So I think when I really, really started enjoying singing, when I was around 14, 15, and I started really, really writing full time when I was 17, 18, that's when I really got into writing. Me and my brother at this time were writing about the same time. We're always just sharing songs, lyrics, ideas, and this is where I found that passion.
That's pretty important because especially your voice, that's when your voice changes, you know?
Yeah, for sure. No, I think I had already gone through that. So I was able to, you know, like, it's definitely like, changed.
This is me. When I sing.
Yeah, exactly. And now, you know, now it's just about that. We just try to perfect whatever we do, anything in our craft. But, you know, we're not that great of a singer, but we do try.
I think I want to talk a little bit about how you maybe identify as an individual in the music that you try to put out, because Gracias, right, be grateful. But you also have another song that's like La Independiente, we kind of also, like, you know, shed light on women that are independent. And so, you know, sometimes in la música regional, that's not what you find. You know, sometimes, you know, it could be about, like, the gang banging aspect of it. So what do you say, how would you define your voice and that music that you try to push out? Is it more positive? What do you try to focus on?
I want people to be able to identify with my music. So I really just base my music off of my own living. And this La Independiente is a song that I wrote. Like you said, to shed light on all those independent women. I see a lot of women on the daily, you know, that don't get enough credit. I think there should be a lot more songs about these women.
And, because it could also be a machista culture, you know?
Yeah, of course, it can. It can. And one thing that we always talk about, like I always talk about, me and my brother always say, because like I told you, he writes too, so what we're always talking about is just not falling under this category that you have to do these type of songs because you're here or you have to. We're not close to or imprisoned in the genre, you know what I mean? So we try to just, whatever we're inspired by, whatever we live, whatever we see, that's what we try to write. This song is inspired by my mom, you know what I mean? And she's such an independent woman, you know, my father's not here no more, you know, he passed away 3 years ago. So I know what she's done even before that. So I wanted to make a song like an anthem for women, and I think they deserve it. I think they deserve a lot more. And well, in the future, we'll be writing a lot more for these women, just women in general.
Gracias came out in 2019. Again in 2020, it's blowing off the charts. You just gotta keep at it.
And you gotta be resilient.
So, okay, lastly, you know, right. You've written songs, you've gotten to collab with a lot of great artists. You get to now sing your own music, write your own music, do that whole pipeline. But what is maybe one highlight in your career at the moment? And I can tell you've done a lot of growth yourself internally as well. What is one or two highlights that you're super grateful for at this moment in this period of your life right now?
I would say, well, in my personal life, I would just say my family, you know, and just being able to really demonstrate what I said I was gonna do. And I think my career-wise is definitely being on Billboard Top 20 has been a highlight for me because it's something that I've really, really dreamed of. I mean, Billboard seemed, I mean, very unreachable. And just when I got the news that we were on Billboard and we debuted, you know, we debuted, I think, 31st, number 31 or something like that. And then when we got to Top 20, we went to 19. It was just very emotional for me. It's very important, and I will cherish it forever, and I value it, and I'm very thankful for these things.
Damn, well, there you have it, everyone. Adrian Chaparro, just doing his thing, sticking to it, being resilient, putting out good music and the positive vibes. And gracias, you know, hopefully it's in top 20, but hopefully it keeps on skyrocketing, you know?
Yes, ma'am. We're hoping for that for sure, and people are definitely responding to it, so. Very thankful. Gracias por todo. Gracias por el apoyo.
Gracias. Thank you for being with us today.
Thank you. God bless you. And hopefully we get to do this interview soon in person.
Definitely.